गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ इन केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर 4 द फाइनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम वॉज गिवन बाय बोर, नील बोर, विच इज नोन एज बोर्स मॉडल ऑफ एटम. सो इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वॉट इज बोर्स मॉडल ऑफ एटम. नाउ इन ऑर्डर टू ओवरकम द ऑब्जेक्शंस रेज्ड अगेंस्ट रदरफोर्ड मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम, व्हाट वर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ रदरफोर्ड? दैट इट कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ एटम. सो नील बोर पुट फॉरवर्ड द फॉलोइंग पोस्टुलेट अबाउट द मॉडल ऑफ एटम. सो व्हाट इज द मॉडल गिवन बाय नील बोर? वेरी फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज, इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज, ओनली सर्टेन स्पेशल ऑर्बिट्स known as discrete orbits of electrons are allowed inside the atom. What he said, that orbits are discrete, special orbits known as discrete orbits. Discrete means separate orbits. So what he said, that electrons revolve in separate orbits. These orbits are known as discrete orbits. And the second point is, while revolving in discrete orbits, the electrons do not radiate energy, as these orbits are having fixed energy. So while revolving in these orbits, electron do not radiate energy. So this is the important point in Bohr model. What he said, that electron revolve in special orbits known as discrete orbits, and in these orbits electron do not radiate energy. So in this way the limitation of Rutherford is removed. Okay, and now these orbits or shells are called energy levels. We are seeing these four orbits here, and these orbits are known as, these circular orbits are known as energy levels, or we can call them as shell also. At the center here it is nucleus. The first orbit is known as K shell, that is n is equal to 1. Second orbit is known as L shell, or we can say number of shell, n is equal to 2. Third is known as M shell, and the next one is known as N shell. Okay, so this is called the Bohr model. These orbits or shells are represented by letter K, L, M, N, or the numbers n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the final Bohr model. And after the Bohr model, there was discovery of neutron. In 1932, J. Chadwick discovered another subatomic particle which had no charge. He discovered new subatomic particle known as neutrons, which was having no charge. Okay, and the mass was equal to proton. So this particle also resides in the nucleus of an atom. Okay, so in this way neutron was discovered. Thank you.